What's crappin', and everybody, welcome back to Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice. We're in hell now, or we're a little bit further into hell now. Going to warn some of you that are watching, this is probably gonna get kind of intense imagery-wise. You've been warned, but my opinion, I'm really excited. I've been looking forward to this all day. I was gonna wait until tomorrow or the day after, but I need to do it. I just wanted to find out what's going on. Look at the heads and all the souls. Oh, this is going to be awesome. Look at this. So cool. Oh, hi, fellas. Uh-oh. Oh, it's been a minute. Hey. Okay. We're gonna have to use some focus on these motherfuckers. Oh god, no, not the shield, dude. Oh, I didn't know I could block that. Or not block it, but parry it more or less, sorry.
They're winning.
Oh, not this dude again. I don't know if you guys remember, but this dude was at the very beginning of the gates. And he messed me up. Working on it, jeez. You know, it's really annoying because sometimes my subtitles show up and sometimes they don't. Oh, hey. Didn't even know you were here at the moment. There's a lot of dudes. Got him. Hey! Knock? Oh, really? Okay. Girls are running a little bit late. Come on. Nice. Oh, is that gonna be everybody? God.
Where are you? Do you hear, Senua? Do you hear the voice of your mother, Galena? She calls for you, Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
By the way, I'd also like to point out that I love that voice. There you go, over here to this hard track. I was just making sure I didn't miss anything. This is so cool. Hashtag demonetize, am I right? All this blood and gore. This is so cool.
Mama! I need you! Help me!
Well, there's Mom. What do I do?
You're dead. You both surrendered to the force.
And your dear beloved mother was powerless against the darkness when it came for her. She too had a sight. She too doubted the gods and let the darkness infest her.
Yeah, but that's not gonna happen to me.
But she didn't love you. She escaped the only way she knew how. She gave her life to the gods.
I feel like there's gonna be more combat up ahead.
The world would have been spared this horror.
I was not incorrect. Oh, this is a new guy.
Late. She's calling for you. Why?
Oh god, he's quick. Ah, come on. Since when do you get axes? Okay, what? There we go. Okay, you're such a douche. Oh, I don't like this guy at all. Clearly. What you mean behind me? Take it. Why? Okay, this is so annoying. Come on. Oh good, another one of those tomahawk guys. Okay, keys. No, God bless America. Oh. I didn't expect to. Of course, there'll be one more. Oh, there's three more. Come on, baby. Come on, send you one, my love. Okay, really? Come on, girlfriend. There we go. Kick. There we go. That's my girl. Nice. Oh my god, there's so many. There is no such thing as a good position in the hallway. Okay. Well, this sucks. Okay, I couldn't even block that, really. Come on. Come on. See, the game keeps auto-saving. Always behind me. Thank you. castle. Okay, this sucks.
Focus now.
Why do you still fight on? Maybe you two should suffer with your brethren in this rot and let your blood seep into the seas and the rivers of hell.
My question is,
give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are.
Is that Hela talking?
Fighting for someone who is already dead. Just look around you. What hope is there for him, even if his soul could be rescued? Do you think he'd thank you for what you have done to him? To his friends, to his father.
Finish.
I'm starting to think that that's Hela talking in just like a distorted voice. I mean, that's just my guess though. All it really is just speculation at this point.
You're both dead. You both surrendered to the voices. The darkness has taken you.
This is so cool. Voice acting though. Someone took it very seriously. This feels mildly like death. I like how it was like kind of realistic though, like you could. Oh. Hello. How are you? I'm gonna name you Herman. Wait, did you nick yourself shaving, buddy? You alright? You gonna be alright? You look like you need a friend, Herman. Oh, look, I can talk to my mom.
I can't fight it anymore.
Got an achievement unlocked called Warrior.
Where are you, Mother? I want to be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world. Follow in the footsteps of her mother. To go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua. Look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
So many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Someone was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me?
Me.
Do you still believe in each other? In us? Yes, darkness come between us.
So this is before she took off to the wilds, I take it. Flashbacks have been kind of all over the place lately. Speaking of darkness.
The hardest battles are fought in the mind.
Wait a second.
He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. But she gave him her word, never to surrender.
I she never even left the island. Damn. I can't believe it. I never even left the island. So wait, so now I have to go there? Oh, I have to go in that door. Forgot all about that giant door. That's tricky. Girls, I've already been here. There's a voice up there growling at me. I don't like it.
Did you miss us? There's a door. You can do it. You can see it. Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
There you go, Senua. Alright, here we go, guys. Going into the mountain. I don't think it'll ever be that cool, though, to be honest with you. It'll never be hell. On second thought, that's pretty damn cool.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
Do I get to face a dragon? Open the door.
Its name, and it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink.
Put on deodorant.
What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
We got this.
Then do it.
We got this, Senua.
The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Alright, well, I might die once or twice or shit, even three times, so let's do this thing then. There you go, get the torch.
Don't be fooled. The beast is still here.
Yeah, but now I have a torch.
No. It's a trick.
Mother, do you hear that?
Don't fall.
It's me, Senua.
The voice.
It's not her.
So full of hate. I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away, and he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
They always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. But they say that I'm already dead.
No, but
They want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't
listen. Do you see them?
Do you see their faces? He's coming! Senor! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Okay.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the ducks.
Stop playing.
She took her own life to escape it.
I have to do a puzzle in the middle of all this.
When her mother lost her smile, her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld.
Alright, can't get in there.
It was a gift taken for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear.
This is so cool.
I don't talk much about her father. Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
It's not going.
Yeah, no, just keep on moving. Oh shit, I gotta go under. Oh boy.
The light's gone out.
Run.
Run, get through it as quick as you can.
Go, lady. Oh my goodness. This is the worst. Get the light, 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 get the light. This thing's gonna swiggity swooty all up in my booty. Alright, yeah, I still gotta find these damn runes. Oh, hey. There's a... There's a P somewhere close to here. Alright, fine. You know what? I don't even care. Yeah, no. Screw you, beastie. So I'm gonna go back through. I'm gonna light all them torches. Aha. Aha, ha, ha, ha. This beast ain't gonna get me now, baby. Nope. Blip. No more torches? Alright, where's that P at? It's saying there's a P somewhere in here. Or, you know, not a P, but... No, I can't see them. Girls.
What are you waiting for? Come on, what the shit? Keep doing it. Follow.
Oh, wait. Oh. 2 more to 5. That's a tricky one. That's not cool. Alright, so I guess that ends it for this way. Oh, hell, come on.
What have you connected with? There's nothing behind the door.
See, Dilly. Just another trick. Just to distract her from her real mission. You don't. Your mother is
Rian the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Reyn reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Reyn. The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the
death. I never went down this way.
Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Alright, door's locked. That one's chained off. I'll go this way. Oh, wait. I'm back at the start. Huh. These gosh darn puzzles, I'll tell you. There we are. I like how you can kind of light the place up a little bit. It's nice. As I say that, I can't do that one. I'm a fan of the sound effect, guys. Alright, so like this. Kind of like that. So I gotta get back behind that door somehow. I've got two more symbols. This is not easy at all. I mean, not that they've been easy as of late, you know, I'm not trying to say that at all. Oh, wait, no, I was just down here. Where, oh, where do I go from here? Maybe I missed him down here. Oh, God.
You're close.
Come on, baby. There you go.
Go anywhere without your light.
Take the torch and move.
I'm working on it. Oh, goodness. I'm just gonna warn you ahead of time, guys. This video is probably gonna end up going a little bit longer than the other ones. So I'm gonna apologize for that ahead of time. There we go. Light this place up. I have a very childish, irrational fear of the dark. So, when it comes to stuff like this, I get very nervous. Alright, where am I looking at? Oh, I get it. Okay. Look down, dummy. There we go.
She has it. She did it. She's done it.
One
this
more.
Place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a child.
We just got one more. Once we open up that door.
Imprisoned in her room at night. The faces in the dark coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. That's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zimbel, could see the monster in her.
This Zimbel guy sounds kind of like a prick. Oh, hey. There's a... Okay. Guys,
the darkness will come again.
I am running as fast as the game will allow me. So if the torch could just not go out, that'd be cool. Okay, cool. Well, there's a door I've been whining about trying to get through. So this is nice. I'm here. Oh, there it is. Oh, there it is. Nice.
Do you feel it? The beast is crawling into your mind, searching for weakness. It found your mother. And used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness. That she's with the gods.
It's
but
a
what
trap.
If they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
Oh. It took her a little bit to start going, didn't it? Oh no. Oh.
No.
What have
no.
you done?
No! No!
You've lost him! It's over!
The darkness is back. You've lost him.
Or he just whooped his ass.
Without his head, you will never bring his soul back. His fate is sealed.
Daddy.
Now it can see you at your weakest. The time you suffered as a child at the hands of your father, Zimbel, will be pined for dear.
Ooh.
Do you remember the darkness, Senor?
I do believe we have another flashback.
The beast is bringing it back.
Sorry, my nose is itchy.
Mother, why did you leave me? This darkness, it's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here.
Alright, well, on that crazy cliffhanger of a note, I'm going to leave this episode here. This episode has been absolutely bonkers when it comes to the story. I mean, Jesus. Yeah, I legitimately thought we were going to spend the rest of the game in hell, like, surrounded by all those hands and heads and everything. I guess we'll never see Herman again. It's kind of sad, but alright. Yeah, no, it's been a crazy episode. I hope you enjoy it. I can't advert it because of all the violence, so, you know, whoever sees it, good on ya. Whoever doesn't, you're missing out. But, yeah, if you like this video, leave it a like. Anything else on the channel, give the playlist a look through. Comment if I missed anything, or if you think there's something I could have done better. Don't forget to subscribe to become a member of the Dirt Family. I will see you guys in the next episode of Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice. Peace!